The band Tease gives props to Miles Goodwin and April Wine. I'm John Bowden from Rock History Canada. We have Mark, Brian, and Mike from the band Tease, three of the four original members, back together, selling out their first show. And as I always say, everyone loves a reunion. They released their last album, Body Shots, in 1980, and now they're back together. In 1979, Miles Goodwin of April Wine produced One Night Stands for the band, an album that a lot of fans say was their very best. Tease was signed to the same label as April Wine, Aquarius Records. And I'd be remiss if I didn't say it would be great to have a reunion with April Wine and Tease in concert, considering how much time they spent together back in the old days. We talked about April Wine.
We're still in touch today. Yeah. We were label mates, right? And so we saw a lot of them back in the day in the office. We toured with them. That was our first major headline tour, not headline, big opening tour across Canada. So we got to know them well. And by the end of the tour, I drunkenly invited Miles to produce our next album, which I had no business doing. But I did. And I ended up being...
One
Night Stands. Ended up being the best decision I ever made under alcohol.
Wait a minute. That's how it came about?
That's how it came about. Yeah.
Yeah.
I think I was
in the room too.
It was after the show. We're in the hotel. We were drinking wine and stuff like that. We're talking. And Miles is telling me, he says, I see you guys every night. He says, I know how you're supposed to sound. You're a guitar band. I know how you're supposed to sound. And I'm thinking, okay, that's great. You know how we're supposed to sound. He says, no. Because I see it. And I said, why don't you just produce the album then, right? Just like that. And then Miles calls Aquarius the next day and said, the band wants me to produce the album, right? And then we get back to Montreal, and I get called into the office, and they're screaming at me, who are you? Who are you to hire the next producer? And I said, I don't really recall doing that. But I guess we kind of did.
Take it a step further. If he would have did Body Shots the way we wanted him to do, but he got busy because harder and faster. Yeah. And it wouldn't have been Nick, right? It should have been Miles. That was the history. We wouldn't be sitting here today 38 years late.
Miles was the guy for us, but April Wine was just taking off then. There was no time. He didn't have time to do it.
And he signed a production deal with Mike Stone, and they were working together. And then Mike ended up dying young. I don't know what happened. But Miles, he just got really busy, and he just couldn't do it. And we were kind of stuck.
Because Miles was really good at arranging material, too. He took a lot of our songs, and he took songs, and I can remember him like, okay, that part's got to go. He helped immensely in that way, and that's sort of overlooked sometimes. Besides the actual production with pushing the knobs and stuff, but he was
One Night Stands.
Was excellent at that. He did a great job.
That's a great album.
And he would have done. He would have done a great job on the next album. He would have taken the songs. And I know he would have cut some of that stuff and done that.
It would be really nice if he produced you now, but I'm just sending that out. Did I just break you up again? Wait a minute. It would be great. It would be great if, you know what? Everyone likes a reunion. Everyone likes a reunion.
I've been pushing for that reunion to work together, you know, and I talked to Brian Greenway in the last couple of days, and I says, you know, let's make this happen. It would be really nice, even if we just did a Montreal show together, because we're both there as label mates. And see what happens from there, or go out east together.
Yeah, but they're
it's different now.
They're like
right?
Big brothers in a way, right? Like, how can you not, you know, how can you not love Jerry Mercer, right? Mercer was just the greatest guy in the world, right? Gary Moffat, just the sweetest guy in the world. Steve Lang, it was a great guy.
Yeah, we lost him, yeah.
Yeah, we learned a lot. I mean, learned a lot about the Canadian business from them, right? From watching their success. When we showed up in Montreal, like being from where we are here, we didn't know a whole lot about April Wine. They didn't mean that much around here in this area.
We're more Windsor.
We're dominated by Detroit radio.
Yeah, Canada ends at London or Chatham, right?
So while April Wine had hits, like Could Have Been a Lady back in the early days of April Wine, before Roller, they didn't mean a whole lot around here. So when we went to Montreal, I was aware of April Wine. I wasn't aware of how big they were or what they meant in this country, right? And then we went on the road with them. I was actually stunned. I said, these guys are loved. They're not just out here slugging. They're loved.
The band Tease have a show coming up with Honeymoon Suite at Matt Minglewood. It's called A Night of Classic Rock, Sunday, August 25th in Liverpool, Nova Scotia. Check out the official page for Tease on Facebook. There'll be links in the description of this video. Also, go there for more show information. We'll let you know as they come in as well. This is an 8-part series. The one you just heard was part 2. This is a new channel. Make sure you subscribe to our channel. It's very, very important to us. And share our videos. When you share our videos on Facebook, it's greatly appreciated. And make sure you comment on them as well. I'm John Bowden. This is Rock History Canada.